Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade with another tutorial in the Coding Fundamentals and GML 2.3 update. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about the changes to arrays, specifically that the 2D array is now dead in 2.3. All arrays are now one-dimensional arrays. You can no longer create 2D arrays, you can only create one-dimensional arrays. However, and this is important, you can nest arrays inside of arrays. Now actually, you could always do this. This was my preferred method even before 2.3, but a lot of people still use 2D arrays because it provided a convenient way of accessing any point in the 2D array with a single line of code. Prior to 2.3, if you had nested arrays, you had to pull out the nested array in order to reference it. That is no longer true, and we'll talk about that in a moment. So as I said, now you must nest one-dimensional arrays to create multi-dimensional arrays, and there's no limit to how deeply you can nest arrays. Also important to note that arrays do not have to be the same length, and we'll see an example of this in a moment. So here are a couple of different ways to create multi-dimensional arrays. One way to do it would be to simply create arrays and then put those arrays inside of another array. This would be a completely valid method, and it would create a large array with two internal arrays. However, you can also do this all in a single line. So for example, here we're creating an array with the exact same information where we have the external array, the big array, and then inside of the big array, we have two other arrays. We have 0, 1, 2, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8. Both of these versions would create an array with the same data. Obviously the difference here is that you'd have two other variables, which may or may not be what you want depending upon the circumstances. Again, I want to stress that this was always possible prior to 2.3. So nothing here has actually changed. What has changed is now this is the only way to create multidimensional arrays. To reference multidimensional arrays, you can now chain accessors. And I'll have a separate tutorial on chaining accessors to go into greater depth, but the array version is very simple. You simply use the standard method of finding a position in an array, so brackets and then the position, close brackets, and then you do that as many times as you need to. So big array 0, 3 would be the big array, so that's this array right here, and then the zeroth position, so that would be this array, and then the third position in this array, 0, 1, 2, 3. And you can access the value that way or set a value that way. Let's actually switch over to GameMaker Studio to see some more examples of this. So here we are in GameMaker Studio 2.3, and I'm going to show you three simple versions to create multidimensional arrays. So the first version, again, would be to create arrays, put them into a variable, and then put those variables into another array. And you can see here that we actually have arrays of different dimensions. So these first two arrays have four positions, and this third array only has two positions. And this would be completely fine. You can also do this in one line, just like this, or, as is common with larger arrays or larger nested structures in general, over multi-lines. So for example, I can just hit enter at these various breaks, and we can see that the two data structures hold the exact same data. It's just that one version is done in one line and one version is done over multiple lines. If you're not familiar with this multiple line version, I would strongly recommend practicing it, as again, it is very useful when you get into working with larger arrays and larger nested data structures. Let's actually see an example now of a three-dimensional array. So here you can see that we have a three-dimensional array where we have our outside array and then our first set of internal arrays and then another set of arrays inside of those arrays. So if you can imagine it, this essentially creates a 3x3 box of values, all of which are currently set to 0. To access values inside of a multidimensional array, again, you just chain the accessors. So to get some practice at this, you can see that we have main array version 2, so we'll use this one, 0, 2, so that's the 0th position, and then the second position, 0, 1, 2, that would be this value right here. So that should hold a value of 2. Main array version 2, 2, 1, 0, 1, 2, that should be this array, 1, 0, 1, that should be this value. So then some value should equal 9. To look at our three-dimensional array, we have 0, so the 0th position, that's this section right here. Then we have 1, so that's 0, 1, that's this array right here. Then we have 1 again, 0, 1, that's this position right here. To set arrays, it's the exact same thing. 0, 2, that would be 0, 0, 1, 2, we would change this value to hello world. And 0, 0, 0 in our 3D array would be this array, this position. Let's actually run this quickly in the debugger. Okay, so here we are in the debugger. We can step through this first part right here, initialize these three arrays, and then add them to main array version 1. There we go. You can see that they're all added in. And we can initialize these next two arrays, and they are also now added in, and they hold the exact same values as version number one did. We can initialize our three-dimensional array the same way by stepping through it. And here we go, our three-dimensional array, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, and 0, 1, 2. And in fact, hopefully looking at it in the debugger like this makes it clear what chaining accessors are doing. So for example, main array version 2, 0, 2, main array version 2, 0, 2. That's the value 2. So if we initialize some value, we now see that some value has the value of 2, exactly what we would expect. And main array version 2, 2, 1 would be main array version 2, 2, 1, the value 9. Again, some value now equals 9. And if we get another value from array 3D, 0, 1, 1, what we should expect is array 3D, 0, 1, 1. That should be the value 0. Now everything is the value 0, so this is a little bit less helpful, but 0, 1, 1, that's how we're getting that position. So you can see that when we are using chained accessors, what we're doing is we're walking through the path that these accessors lead. So 0, 1, 1 was 0, 1, 1. So now we can go up to main array version 1, 0, 2, and set that value to hello world. Main array version 1, 0, 2. We should expect this to change to hello world. There we go. It has changed to hello world. And now we should expect the same thing for 0, 3, 3. And because I didn't put another line of code after that, I've got to go check it in all instances. But we can see array 3D, 0, 0, 0. So 0, 0, 0, hello world. So there you go, a brief overview of multidimensional arrays. Again, I want to stress that everything that we just talked about up here with creating multidimensional arrays was possible prior to 2.3. What is new in 2.3 is this chaining accessors. Another thing that is new in 2.3 is that some of the array functions have changed. Array length 1D, 2D, and array height 2D are all deprecated and replaced with array length because, of course, if you only have one-dimensional arrays, you don't need to distinguish between these different things. Also, very nicely, we now have array resize. You can use this to make arrays larger, but also smaller. And that's something that you couldn't do before 2.3. There was no way to make arrays smaller prior to 2.3. Now there is. I've also discovered that array equals works on nested arrays when it did not used to, and there might be other differences in different functions that I haven't discovered yet, but array length and array resize are new, and array equals works slightly different than it did before. So in summary, 2D arrays are dead and gone. All arrays are now one-dimensional arrays, and you can nest them as deeply as you want. Remember that they don't even have to have the same length. And what is truly new in 2.3 is that you can chain accessors to reference these nested arrays in a single line of code. Array functions have also changed. You have array length and array resize, allowing you to shrink arrays. As always, the links in this slide will be below. I have two links to the manual on arrays and array functions, and I also have a link to a YoYo blog on the updates to arrays and other GML functions as well. And that's it. Thanks for watching.